to start your 11th lecture, 11th science lecture. I'm going to teach you chemistry. So chemistry, the first chapter of chemistry, that is the some basic concepts of chemistry. So here first you should know the definition of chemistry. Chemistry means study of matter, their physical and chemical properties, chemical properties at different conditions. Conditions kutle astat, so which type of conditions? At different type of condition, environmental condition, different environmental condition, or changing pressure, or changing temperature, or etc. So that is called the different conditions. That is called different conditions. So study of matter. So first you should know the matter. So matter means what? So matter means any object that has
mass and volume. That
object is called as a matter. Any object, for example, any object that has a mass and volume. Any object, take an example of suppose sugar. Sugar is a chemical. You know the chemical. For example, the glucose. The formula of glucose is C6H12O6. So it contains the elements. So elements means study of chemistry. Elements comes under the study of chemistry. So study of chemistry, all objects made by the elements. You know the periodic table. So there are more than 100 elements are in periodic table. Already seen in 10th standard, that is here is a S block, D block, P block and A block elements. The elements are systematically distributed depending upon their increasing atomic number and last element entered in which orbital. Depending upon that, it is grouped into S, P, D, A blocks. We will see it afterward. Okay. Now see here, the study of matter that has a mass and volume. For example, this glucose. Glucose has mass as well as its volume also. So any liquid. So liquid sudha has mass asta. For example, the water. Whether it is a pure water or impure water can be studied by using in lab. And afterward you come to know. That means the change in physical and chemical properties. Study of physical and chemical properties comes under this chemistry. So afterward these central science. So chemistry is a central science. It is related to all subjects. Chemistry is a central science. It is related to different subjects. Such as, for example, chemistry. It is related to different subjects such as physics, then biology, geography or environmental science, engineering, medical science, for example, forensic science, applied chemistry, then space science. Okay, earth and space. Earth, earth and space science, etc., etc. That means this chemistry is a central science, central subject. It is required. This chemistry subject is required for the study of physics, for the study of biology, environmental science, medical science, applied science, or space and etc. Applied science or space and earth science. How it is related to physics, chemistry? This chemistry subject, how it is related to physics, biology, environment, medical science, or engineering? On engineering. So see here. So first physics. So you know the physics. So see the basic concept. That is passing of current from one point to other point. Passing of current from one point to other point. Suppose there is a suppose you have taken the wire of iron or wire of another elements like as for example copper, iron, or suppose it is a non-conductor of electricity. Suppose a wood. Suppose a wood. Wood is a non-conductor of electricity. So you are iron or copper wire. So you should know the study of these elements. These elements contain free electrons in their outermost shell. Then that it conducts electricity. While in case of wood, there is no any free electron, and hence here the knowledge of chemistry is required. Here the knowledge of chemistry is required, and afterward the passing of current from one point to other point takes place. So here the, for example, taken in physics, the knowledge of chemistry is required. Now biology. Now you know the different biology, the plant and animal. So plants and animal. So suppose we want to grow the plants. Suppose we want to grow the plants. So agriculture field. Suppose in agriculture field, which type of fertilizer we want to use? Suppose for the proper growth of plants, the soil should be alkaline medium. Soil should have the alkaline medium. Suppose that alkaline medium is not maintained. So how to maintain that alkaline medium? How to maintain that alkaline medium for the proper growth? By adding some fertilizer. Which type of fertilizers? You know the different type of fertilizer, that is urea, for example. You know the urea, ammonium phosphate. So these are the chemicals. These are the chemicals. So here we require the knowledge of chemistry. We require the knowledge of chemistry. In case of environmental science. In case of environmental science, environment, you know the environment. Environment made by the different type of gases, or this air. Air contains the different type of gases. Suppose it is contaminated by using some other poisonous gases. Then which type of gas is entered in air? You should know. Then moisture. किती moisture है हवेमध्ये? आपल्याला आजची काय कंडिशन आहे? आपल्याला किती प्रमाणात मॉइश्चर आहे किंवा पाऊस पडेल का? या टाईपचं सगळं नॉलेज रिक्वायर्ड कम्स अंडर द केमिस्ट्री. सो स्टडी ऑफ एन्व्हायरमेंटल केमिस्ट्री कम्स अंडर दॅट स्टडी ऑफ एन्व्हायरमेंटल केमिस्ट्री. नाउ मेडिकल सायन्स, फॉरेन्सिक सायन्स. फॉर एक्झाम्पल इन मेडिकल सायन्स, सो विच टाईप ऑफ केमिकल वॉन्ट टू गिव्ह दॅट पर्सन इन डिफरंट कंडिशन. आता सपोज one of the chemical or suppose one of the drug or medicine is, which type of medicine is used for the headache? Because these chemical he je chemical asat the chemical proper headache la upyogi kasa padta mhanje tithe sudha aplo kay ahe chemical kutla asna chemistry tacha study kelya shivay aplyala kutlo chemical vaprav lagnar ahe aplyala kalnar nahi. That means the use of chemistry in medical science. Then forensic science. Suppose आपण टीव्हीवर बघतो की हा मनुष्य इतका इतका वेळ झालं मरून, म्हणजे डेथ झाली, त्याची कधी डेथ झाली, तर याच्यावरून आपल्याला काय कळतं की तिथे आपल्याला स्टडी ऑफ केमिकल, द इंटेक ऑफ कार्बन, कार्बन डायऑक्साइड रिमूव्ह करतो आपण आणि आत घेतो कार्बन डायऑक्साइड बाय युझिंग द रेस्पिरेशन प्रोसेस. In case of respiration process, carbon dioxide is evolved. So, त्याच्यावरून आपल्याला हे फॉरेन्सिक सायन्स आपल्याला स्टडी करायचं आहे. देन आफ्टर इंजिनिअरिंग, इंजिनिअरिंग मध्ये सेम टाइप ऑफ विच टाइप ऑफ मटेरियल, इट इज बिकॉज दिस केमिस्ट्री इज रिलेटेड टू मटेरियल केमिस्ट्री, इट इज रिलेटेड टू मटेरियल सायन्स. सो डिफरंट टाइप्स ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट्स विच आर रिक्वायर्ड इन इंजिनिअरिंग, इंजिनिअरिंग सो स्टडी ऑफ दॅट ऑब्जेक्ट फर्स्ट यू शुड नो अँड आफ्टरवर्ड दी दॅट मीन्स दिस इन द इंजिनिअरिंग study of chemistry is essential. Then applied science, different type of applied science, for example the polymer chemistry, for example polymer chemistry, polymer, different type of polymers like its cloth, different type of clothes, there we require the knowledge of chemistry, there we require the knowledge of chemistry. Then earth and space science, earth मध्ये space मध्ये काय चालले की suppose हा material हे आपल्याला लॉन्च करायचं, सपोज आपल्याला हा हा सॅटेलाइट लॉन्च करायचा, लॉन्च करायला त्याची थिकनेस किती पाहिजे, ते कसलं मटेरियल पाहिजे, म्हणजे ते स्पेस मध्ये आपल्याला या या स्पीडनी जाऊ शकतं, या या स्पीडनी जाऊ शकतं, कुठलं फ्युएल लागेल, फ्युएल किती लागेल, तर या सगळ्याचा स्टडी. सो बेसिकली दॅट फ्युएल मीन्स केमिकल, बेसिकली दॅट फ्युएल मीन्स केमिकल. सो स्टडी ऑफ दीज थिंग्स कम्स अंडर अर्थ अँड स्पेस सायन्स. सो this chemistry is a subject which is related to material chemistry, material related to material, its knowledge is very important to study the all the subjects. Now next is a scope of chemistry. So scope of chemistry, हार्डनेस इन्क्रीज करण्यासाठी कुठलं इलिमेंट्स त्याच्यामध्ये सपोज फिशिंग नेट बनवे अपना फिशिंग नेट नेट मे का पानी टाकतो मासे पकड़ो ठीक है। जर सपोज ती नेट जर मासे कुरतडली तर आपल्याला मग ते मासे मिळत नाही याचा अर्थ नेट विच टाइप ऑफ नेट्स वी वांट हाउ टू प्रिपेयर प्रिपरेशन ऑफ नेट इज इम्पॉर्टंट फॉर एग्जाम्पल टेकन सो नाउ ऑल्सो द पॉलिमर दैट मीन्स प्लास्टिक सो डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ प्लास्टिक ऑब्जेक्ट्स कम्स अंडर दिस पॉलिमर केमिस्ट्री। आपल्याला कॉस्ट पण जास्त नको असते कॉस्ट पण कमी पाहिजे असते मटेरियल पण चांगलं पाहिजे असते पण डिपेंडिंग अपॉन दैट दी which material you have to use during the preparation of that material aapkala study of chemistry is essential in that case so scope of chemistry in polymer in case of cloth we know the polyester chemistry polyester aapkala maithi kasla apan kapad mhanto polyester kapad polyester or cotton cloth cotton cloth cotton cotton madhe kasla cotton सो कार्बन हाइड्रोजन ऑक्सीजन दीज आर द बेसिक इलेमेंट्स सो कॉटन देन जूट देन पॉलीइस्टर पॉलीइस्टर इस्टर आर सी डबल वन ओ ओ आर आर एंड आर डैश मे बी सेम और डिफरेंट दिस ग्रुप इज कॉल्ड एज इस्टर ग्रुप सो पॉलिस्टर इन क्लोथ क्लोथ ऑफ पॉलिस्टर कंटेन ग्रुप कुठला असतो त्याच्यामध्ये या टाइपचा ग्रुप असतो सो so study of that chemicals so scope of chemistry in case of to the cloth then food industry in preparation of different jams and jellies suppose jams jellies so here the jams and jellies here the preservatives are added some preservatives are added so which type of preservative preserve the taste color of that compound of that food so here the maintenance or quality control comes under this chemistry so scope of chemistry to the food industry also scope of chemistry to the food industry also then suppose petrol so petrol diesel so these are the पेट्रोल डीजेल हे सुद्धा काय येतात आपले स्कोप ऑफ केमिस्ट्री इन टू दॅट फील्ड ऑल्सो स्कोप ऑफ केमिस्ट्री इन दॅट फील्ड ऑल्सो दो सेपरेशन ऑफ क्रूड ऑइल कॅन बी डिराइव ऑर इट इज कुठून काढलं जातं जमिनीतून काढलं जातं त्या क्रूड ऑइल मध्ये डिफरंट टाइप ऑफ कॉम्पोजिशन दॅट इज पेट्रोल डिझेल कॅरोसिन ग्रीस एक्सेट्रा सो दीज आर दी कंटेंट्स यू हॅव टू सेपरेट आउट by the knowledge of the chemistry so there is a scope of chemistry there is also a scope of chemistry so scope of chemistry in different things because chemistry is a related to material chemistry is related to material now the nature of chemistry next point is a nature of chemistry so nature of chemistry that means different branches of chemistry so instead of nature write different branches of chemistry so branches of chemistry first branch suppose the physical chemistry suppose first branch is a physical chemistry so in case of physical chemistry study of different rules principles study of different rules principles of environment or study of different rules and principles of environment or during formation of matter or in formation of matter principles of formation of matter or required for the study of matter different rules that means hydrogen and oxygen so there is a formation of water molecule by using the oxygen gas and hydrogen gas okay this hydrogen and oxygen combine to form a water molecule so here knowledge. That is, during the formation of the water, the two molecules of hydrogen combined with one molecule of oxygen, formation of a water. So it is in liquid state. So combination, study of combination. Then the study of conservation of mass. You know the conservation of mass, conservation of energy. So one form is converted to another form of energy. Energy of universe is constant. Energy of universe is constant. It converts from one form to other form. That is the law. So comes under this physical chemistry. Then the study of conservation of mass. Same things like as energy. Here the conservation of mass and energy supports. So mass. So mass of hydrogen and oxygen is equal to the mass of water. Is equal to the mass of water. That means the masses of reactant is equal to the masses of product. So this type of study is comes under the physical chemistry. Then next is inorganic chemistry. Inorganic chemistry. So we know that inorganic chemistry the study of elements other than carbon. So we know the different more than 100 elements are present in periodic table. So study of these elements, their compounds comes under inorganic chemistry. Other than carbon compound like CO2, carbon monoxide or CS2. These materials comes under inorganic chemistry. But the study of carbon compound like carbohydrate, protein, fats comes under organic chemistry. So study of these compounds comes under inorganic chemistry. Now next is the study of organic chemistry. So organic chemistry is the study of carbon compound. Means study of carbon compound. You know the carbon compound like as carbohydrate, protein, fats, etc. So carbohydrate, protein, fats. So study of these compounds. Then crude oil content, alkane, alkene, alkyne, like as these elements, right? Petrol, diesel, kerosene. So study of these compounds comes under organic chemistry. Then next is the analytical chemistry. Then next is the analytical chemistry. So analytical chemistry, study of different estimation, different type of processes, separation, estimation, processes. So detection, separation, estimation, detection. So study of detection of any elements, for example, separation. Suppose the two compounds mix to form one mixture. So we want to separate these two mixture by using these analytical techniques. Then estimation. So all this separation process or different type of processes comes under the study of analytical chemistry. Then environmental chemistry. So environmental chemistry, that means the study of environmental material. Study of environmental material. Environment, you know the environment, air. Air madhe kutle gases astat, that you know. Air ajun kay asta environment madhe, tar aapla surrounding portion sagla, tyachyamadhe water ala, earth madhe different conditions. कुठे हिमालय मध्ये वेगळी अर्थ आहे तिथे काय असतं किंवा राजस्थान मध्ये काय असते तिकडे वाळू असते सगळी मग कसलं मटेरियल आहे तिथे टॅग मॉइश्चर आहे का किंवा या सगळ्याचं स्टडी कम्स अंडर दिस एन्व्हायरमेंट और वॉटर इज पोल्युटेड फॉर एक्झाम्पल वॉटर इज पोल्युटेड झालंय हवा पोल्युट झाली हे सगळं कशामध्ये येतं एन्व्हायरमेंटल केमिस्ट्री मध्ये येतं The next is a nuclear chemistry, study of nucleus, not biological nucleus, but the study of nucleus, element center madhe ka asto nucleus asto, it contain proton, electron, neutron. So suppose we want to prepare that atom bomb tayar karayacha aplyala, atom bomb kutle elements combine kele ki atom bomb tayar nuclear chemistry. Now suppose next is a biochemistry. Biochemistry मधे काय इतना the study of all the subjects like as biology or related to life science. Related to life science. The life study. आपल्याला जीवन जग म्हणजे फॉर एक्झाम्पल कार्बोहायड्रेट प्रोटीन फॅट्स यांचा सुद्धा आपण त्याचे वेगळे वेगळे एन्झाइम्स आपल्या शरीरामध्ये हे जे शरीर कशाने बनलेले बॉडी मेड बाय द इलेमेंट्स इलेमेंट्स बेसिकली द इलेमेंट्स कंबाइन टू फॉर्म डिफरंट इलेमेंट्स कंबाइन टू फॉर्म इन प्रॉपर मॅनर टू प्रोड्युसेस लाईफ सो दीज इलेमेंट्स दॅट इज फॉर एक्झाम्पल I have told you now the different elements combine in proper manner to form a life. So these protein, carbohydrate, fats, minerals, enzymes, these are the basic compounds required for the proper growth of animals and plants. So study of these elements, study of these things comes under biochemistry. So, the scope of chemistry or nature of chemistry is very vast because it is related to material science. Now, the matter means the mass, any object. Matter means any object which has a mass, any object. Any objects which has a mass and volume. So here the matter means any object which has a mass and volume. Any object which has a mass and volume. So matter is divided into pure substance is divided into pure substance and mixture. It is divided into pure substance and mixture. So matter means any object which has mass and volume. Which has a mass and volume that is called as a matter. So matter is divided into pure substance and mixture. Now mixture means mixture. So mixture homogeneous, heterogeneous. So mixture. So first see the chart. Pure substance, pure elements and compounds. These elements metal, non-metal and metalloid. Suppose the matter any object which has a mass and volume. Any object which has a mass and volume is called as a matter. This matter is divided into pure substance and mixture. So this pure substance is divided into elements and compounds. An element is divided into metal, non-metal, and metalloid. So pure substance is formed by one kind of elements. Suppose compounds or elements is it is a pure substance. It contains only one kind of elements or compound. For example, pure water. This pure water contains the elements, number of H2O elements. Pure water contains number of H2O elements. That means it is a pure substance. It contains only formula of this compound. By using analysis, we come to know that pure water contains H2O. Now pure substance it is divided into elements and compounds. So elements and compounds. So first you should know the elements. So which cannot be break, elements which can't be break. The elements is a any pure substance we can't break, or any pure substance which is unbreakable, which cannot be broken down into simpler, any pure substance which cannot be broken into simpler form. So simpler form. So elements, any pure substance which cannot be broken into simpler form, that is called as a elements. And compound, and next is a compound. So compound, it is a group of elements. You know the elements, carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, for example. Carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, etc. Chlorine, bromine, etc. So it is a group of elements combined in definite proportion. The group of elements compound. The group of elements combined in definite manner to form compound. For example, the water. For example, the copper sulfate. So these are group of elements. These are the group of elements combined in proper manner to form these compounds. To form this compound, they combine in proper manner, specific manner. See, it is called as a compound. Now the element, it is again divided into matter. Is divided into matter means any object which has a mass and volume. It is divided into mixture and pure substance. So pure substance, it is divided into elements and compound. Elements, any pure substance which cannot be broken down into a simpler form. And compound, it is a group of elements combined in definite manner to form a compound. Now these elements, metal, non-metal, metalloid. So first you should know the metal. Metal means which has a luster. Luster means what? Chakaki. Means what? Chakaki. Luster, then ductile, malleability. Which one? Malleability. Malleable. Okay? Which has a malleable, ductile and luster. Luster म्हणजे चकाकी. बघा तांब्याचं भांडं कसं चकाकी असते. ठीक आहे? तर चकाकी असते. Ductile, which can be drawn into metal can be drawn into a thin wire, that is called ductile. Then malleability means which can be there is a formation of thin sheet of material, patra ek banvaycha asa, thin patra banvaycha, that is called malleability. So the metal has a luster, ductile nature, malleability, it conduct the heat and electricity. That these elements are comes under the metal. The non-metal, which has no luster, are not malleable, not ductile, do not conduct heat and electricity. That type of material is called as a non-metal. And metalloid. So metalloid is the material has a intermediate character. That means mixing of metal shows the characteristics of metal as well as non-metal. Shows the characteristics of metal and non-metal. Comes under the metalloid. Then the next find is a matter is divided into mixture and real substance. So mixture, it is divided into homogeneous mixture and heterogeneous mixture. So homogeneous mixture means two or more substances or compounds mixed together to form a miscible means you can mix one another to form a uniform mixture. That mixture is called as a homogeneous mixture. For example, sugar solution. For example, the sugar solution, sugar solid form, water liquid form. This sugar is combined to form a homogeneous mixture. Combined to form a homogeneous, miscible, completely miscible with each other. So that is called as a homogeneous mixture. Then heterogeneous mixture. That means the mixture which is not miscible. The two or more compounds which are not miscible with each other, we can separate it from the mixture. Suppose the water and oil. Oil has a lower density which occupy the upper portion. Water has a higher density which occupy the lower portion of the container. And then we can separate these two compounds from each other. That is called the heterogeneous mixture. So thank you. Start studying. Thank you.